a simple technique to arthroscopic Bankart repair. So what we do is we make a posterior viewing portal, and then we make two portals on the anterior side. One is an anterior superior portal and one is an anterior portal. The anterior superior portal should be made parallel to the glenoid, and the anterior portal should be made at the junction between the biceps and the subscapularis. So this is the final view of the portals that we made, and this is the structure. This is the structure which you see upwards is the, now we insert our scope in the anterior superior portal, and we can see that whole of the humeral head is dislocated anteriorly, and there is an ELISA kind of a lesion. And the best and most important step here is to release the ELISA lesion down from the glenoid neck nicely, elevating it sequentially, and you should go up to the subscapularis muscle belly, release it from top to the bottom, go up to the 6 o'clock position down. You can even go more inferiorly. You can release as much of the tissue as possible, and the more you do a release, the more you will be able to approach this tissue, the capsulolateral complex, to its normal level, because this is healed in a more inferior position. So if you see that the whole of the ELISA complex is much more medially attached to the glenoid neck, and release is very important. If you see, these are the subscapularis muscle belly, and these must be seen. So once you do a thorough release, you should see the subscapularis muscle belly, and this is the tissue in which we can see the capsulolateral complex, and the humeral head is still back. Then what we do is we'll insert the remplissage anchor from the low posterolateral portal, and usually in this particular case we are using a wedge metal anchor which is inserted at the junction of the cartilage and the bone defect. So the number of anchors will depend to the size of the defect. If the defect is less than 2 cm, you can use a single anchor, and in this the wedge anchor is inserted in the defect itself. We use a double loaded anchor, 5 mm. A metal anchor is preferred because you can do it in a single step. And then you need to pass your suture limbs from the tendinous part of the infraspinatus and the teres minor. Mind you should not pass it through the muscular part, because that will restrict the external rotation. And so you can use your penetrating suture device to pass. I usually pass in only two, one, the first pass is a single pass and the second pass is a double pass, and through that we will just keep it, the tissue passed. And these tissues for remplissage should not be tied at this time. We can just keep the sutures as it is, but these sutures can definitely be used as a traction suture to pull the tissue. These sutures should not be tied at this time because we want to reduce it. So now we go with your arthroscopic labral repair. We already released the ELISA tissue, and now we insert our first anchor. The first anchor is inserted at around 5:30 o'clock position. In this particular case, we are using a single loaded Iconics anchor, and in this particular video we have just shown a very simple technique. We have not shown any fancy techniques, a simple technique which is easier to do, specifically for a beginner surgeon. So now what we do is we insert the Iconics anchor from the anterior portal, and once we insert the anchor, we can remove the inserter, and then we can remove the guide sheet as well. Once we do that, we need to take out one of the thread through the anterior superior portal. So we need one thread in both of the cannulas. Once we do that, what we need to do is we need to have a pass. You can use an ideal suture shuttle or any other suture shuttle, and this suture shuttle needs to pass the capsulolateral complex, and principally it should pass inferior to the anchor. And when you pass the capsulolateral complex through the passing device. The passing device should exit inferior to the anchor, and that is why we will be able to achieve a good inferior to superior lateral shift, and we'll be able to give a good stability to the shoulder joint. So in this particular case, we are passing the sutures through the capsulolabral complex, and this should exit inferior to the anchor which we have inserted. Once it is, we can see the tip, we just pass on the chia, and this chia is grabbed by the suture grasper and it is loaded outside. So this chia is grabbed through the anterior superior portal, and this is now, the chia is now loaded with the fiber wire, and this is pulled on the other side. Now this is a tissue limb. Now we will make this tissue limb as the post, and we'll tie a sliding locking knot. So we'll tie a sliding locking knot through a anterior portal, and we usually use a SMC knot in this particular case. And once we pass the knot inside, the first knot itself will give a significant stability to the shoulder. So once we tie this knot in, we can see that the shoulder is stabilized with a single knot. The structure that you see on top here is the MTHL ligament, and this one knot will give a stability to the joint, and the shoulder joint is reduced to its own position. Now we'll repeat the steps. The second anchor is usually inserted at 4:30 o'clock position. You can just debride a little bit of cartilage on the face of glenoid for this particular purpose. And then what you need to do is you need to just pass the same steps. You need to pass one of the limbs through the anterior superior portal. And then again, use your ideal suture shuttle or whatever suture shuttle devices you are confident with to again pass it through the capsulolabral complex. Now it is your wish to incorporate the MGHL or not. Most of the surgeons do it. There are some surgeons who don't like to incorporate the MGHL, but I do personally like to incorporate the MGHL. And again, as I told you, your chia should escape inferior to the anchor and inferior to the anchor threads that you have inserted. And once you have taken it, the chia out, you should load it with the wire. And once the wire is passed, once you pass the tissue, the fiber wire which is passing through the tissue as the post, and you tie again a sliding locking knot nicely onto that. And after passing the two knots, the most of the stability of the shoulder will be there, and shoulder will be reduced to its normal position. At this point of the time, you will also notice that your Hill-Sachs lesion has gone way posterior and it is not coming into your way. Now, as I told you, it is imperative to put at least 3 anchors. Less than 3 anchors, the recurrence rate is high. So I'll recommend all of you to put the third anchor. This is at around 3:30 position, and we usually incorporate this particular anchor. We use the capsulolabral complex as well as the capsule, and this occasionally in very, very unstable patient, you can incorporate a part of subscapularis tendon also into this part of the repair, although this is controversial and not all surgeons do it. Again, whenever you pass the chia, it should escape below the anchor which you have inserted. We'll railroad the anchor threads, pass it out through the tissue, and then you need to tie it back to its original position. And once you tie it back, the capsulolabral repair is done, and you will have a very nice solid repair that you see on the anterior inferior side of glenoid labrum. Now at this point of time, you may insert your scope anteriorly and see what is the status of your reduction. So now in this particular video, you can see that the whole of your humeral head was subluxating outside the shoulder, but now you can see that it is very well reduced. The humeral head is centering well over the glenoid, and you can see that there is a very nice capsulolabral repair of the anterior inferior labrum. And then you can just do your amplicized sutures from outside. I usually tie it just back. You need to take care that you don't incorporate the skin. You have to avoid the skin dimpling, and usually the process is done. If you have any questions regarding to this repair, you can upload it on the comment box. We will be very happy to answer. Thanks a lot.